swing. You'd be smiling and we would sing. Amazing grace, and Jesus loves me. You were like my mother.
We're here today, Lord, that thing's loud. We're here today to celebrate the life of Willie Mae Joyner, which was only 2 weeks ago to the day we celebrated the life of her husband, Alfie. Oh, I know it's a rough time for the family, the children especially, but the Bible tells us every one of us got an appointed day to die, amen. But she was born on Tuesday, November the 30th, 1937, in Boonville, Mississippi. She passed away Tuesday, February the 2nd, Savannah, Georgia. She was 83 years, 2 months, and 3 days. She was survived by three children, Ronnie Joyner, wife Kathy of Waycross, Donna Jean Joyner of Millwood, Lisa Boatwright, husband Keith of Waycross, son-in-law Mike Waters of Waycross, 10 grandchildren, 19 great-grandchildren, a brother Herschel Stacy, wife Deanna of Blackshear, two sister-in-laws, Dolores O'Berry, Jarrell Davis, numerous nieces and nephews. I was looking over the obituary that Rodney and them had put on Facebook, and I was praying and asking the Lord what he would have me to speak today, and as I was reading over this, I noticed that in the comments said that, if I can find it, that there we go. She had retired 26 years from Reuben Brothers Footwear Anybody that can survive 26 years of working at Reuben Brothers has paid their toll, amen. Some of these young ones have no idea what I'm talking about. But for those of you that ever worked there, knew what that was. And I was thinking as I was reading some of this stuff that, you know, she had to be a tough woman. 26 years of Reuben Brothers and a lifetime of Alvey. She had to be a tough woman, amen. And it led me to a passage of scripture that most all of you are very familiar with. And it's found in Proverbs 31. It says, who can find a virtuous woman? It says, for her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doeth safely trust in her, so that she shall have no need of spoil, or he shall have no need of spoil. So that she will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like a merchant's ship. She bringeth her food from afar. She raises also while it is still yet night and giveth meat unto her household and a portion to her maidens. So she considereth the field and buyeth it with the fruit of her hands and planteth a vineyard. Says she grindeth her loins with strength and strengtheneth her arms. She perceiveth that her merchandise is good, her candle goeth not out by night. She layeth her hands to the spindle and her hands hold the distaff. She stretches out her hands to the poor. Yea, she reaches forth her hand to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. So she maketh herself coverings of tapestry. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates, where he sitteth among the elders of the land. She findeth fine linen and selleth it. She delivereth girdles unto the merchants. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She openeth her mouth with wisdom, and her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well into the ways of her husband, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Her children arises up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou exceedeth them all. Favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. I was thinking the first time that I can remember Willie May was when my father passed away in 1970. And Millwood has always been blessed by everybody coming out and helping each other. And I remember her bringing a covered dish and sitting down and talking with Mama after Daddy had passed away. And from then, I have seen her at various times doing, you know, same thing with other homes, needy families, whatever, of being able to assist as many other women in Millwood do. A lot of them do. But I thought about the passage of Scripture that Paul wrote in 1 Timothy 6 and 7. And it says, well, we brought nothing into this world, and it's certain we'll carry nothing out. You know, we make do with what God gives us, and we can bless ourselves, our homes, our family, as well as we bless others. And, you know, she was always a lady to me. Every time I seen her, she would have a smile on her face, and she was willing to greet you. And, you know, I was reading a passage, or not a passage, but I was reading comments, and me and technology don't get along too well. And I hope it don't offend nobody by reading this, but a grandson had made a comment on it. And he said this, said, I'm sure going to miss the trips to Millwood on Sunday for Sunday dinners, sitting in the corner of the kitchen watching Granny cook, and then yelling to the living room, it's ready. Y'all better get in here if you want to eat it. And I thought, you know, that was fitting. And I remember Halvey making a comment one time that he had rocked on a little bit after lunch. And he told me, said, well, said, I'm going to have to go to the store and get something to eat. Said, because when Willie Jean puts it on the table, or Willie May, excuse me, puts it on the table, said, if you ain't there to eat it and she puts it up, you don't go in and take it back down. Said, you eat when it's there. And, you know, she was a lady that would be, you know, commemorable to be anybody's companion as far as a wife. And like the Bible said, you know, she was somebody that all we could be proud of. You know, you never heard no tearing down or anything else, you know, in the relationship they had together. And it talked about, you know, her husband being proud of her. And, you know, that says a lot. And, you know, as we all would see all of you around different places, and especially the store, if you hung around the store very much or went into the store. But, you know, his comment was a lot of times says, well, I got to go home because if I don't, she's going to skin me. But, you know, Willie Jean was a lady that regardless of the situation that she was, I see Willie Jean, y'all know me. I'm allowed to call you Fred before it's over with. Willie Mae was one that regardless of where you seen her, she was going to greet you with kindness. And throughout the years, that says a lot when you maintain that kind of a relationship between you and the people that are around you. And as I've said many times before, and Brother Clayton and all of us, you know, you preach your own funeral as you live. People know you the way that you live. Regardless of what anybody says, you know, you're not going to preach anybody into heaven, and you're sure not going to preach them into hell. That, you know, you are who you are, and that's what people remember, amen. And she was a lady of the Millwood community that was well respected. Let us bow our heads, if you will. Heavenly Father, we do thank you again today, Lord, Father, for this celebration. We thank you for the life, dear Lord, that Willie Mae Joyner lived, dear Lord, in front of us all. Lord, she was a lady, dear God, Lord, that, Father, represented, Lord, what marriage was all about. She represented what motherhood was all about, Lord. Father, she was one, dear Lord, that took care of her husband. Lord, we commend, dear God, Lord, all that she done. We thank you, dear Lord, to be able to be a part of that, Lord, the acquaintance, Lord, of this family, the children, Lord. Father of the kinship, dear God, Lord, I pray, dear Lord, blessings, dear Lord, upon this family. Lord, we know, dear God, Lord, it's a tragical thing, Lord, within just a few short days, Lord, to lose your father, sister, Lord, and your mother. But, Lord, I pray, dear God, Lord, that help each one to realize, dear God, Lord, it's a celebration, Lord, for the life they live. And, Lord, one thing about it, dear God, Lord, it's full of memory. Lord, as we read, Lord, about the grandson, Lord, those are the things, dear God, Lord, that carry us through the hard times. And, Father, I pray, dear God, blessings, dear God, Lord, upon this family, Lord, as you carry them through, Lord. And, Father, I pray, dear God, to sustain them, dear Lord, in the days to come and the holidays, Lord. Father, to be able to remember all the good times and the good things that were said and done. Lord, we thank you for all that you do for each of us, and we ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Tell me, what does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? Does the sun shine bright forever? Have your fears and your pain gone away? Yeah. 'Cause here on earth it feels like everything
Well, we're back again, as Bobby said. We don't know who will be next, but the Lord does. We'd like to say to the family, our heart goes out to you. You really, really had it the last whole month, and other than that. I was thinking about, he said that she worked at Reuben Brothers. I had a sister work here, different ones. And said one time they found a body out there on the railroad. And said this, somebody said, well, what? Who you reckon it is? One of them said it's like, it looks like a monkey dried up. Said, no, I don't believe it's a monkey. Somebody walked up and said, that's one of them Reuben Brother workers. They done got the goody out of that. But I tell you, Willie Mae didn't. She didn't retire. Sister Harold, I had to just about be on the run all the time, stay up with her. She's from one satellite to the other, you know, them houses where they keep people and feed them. And she'd made about the third move, and I caught up with her. And when I went in there, lo and behold, there's Willie Mae. And she was her cook, and she was a good one, too. She tried to get me to eat several times while I was there. I never did. But she's always, as Bobby said, a good, pleasant lady. I knew her when her and Alvy was courting. As Stephanie says, back in the day. But, you know, we're in the day-to-day. A lot of people's ready to meet God in peace, and a lot of them ain't. That's the sad part. But the Bible says, be ready in such an hour as you think not. The Son of Man's coming. Somebody thinks that's the end of the time. It is for you. When you draw your last breath, and there's nowhere that you can get ready when you leave from here. It's here or never. And we got two destinations. We don't like to hear about them too much. One of them's heaven, the other one's hell. And, you know, you ain't got no business in hell. And if you go there, you go as an intruder. I remember years ago, my uncle, he's bad to drink at times. Thank God he straightened up before we passed. But Uncle Johnny, never married. And he said he went and, you know, he'd go in jail. And they, what you doing breaking in here? What are y'all breaking in here on us? Said, man, I ain't breaking in. Said, you are. So we're going to have court. They had kangaroo court. And then they'd whip you if you didn't have no money to pay them. You know, that'd be a bad predicament, wouldn't it? Be in jail, and then somebody going to beat on you because you broke into jail. But that's the way it was. But I don't think they done him too bad. He'd get back in again once in a while. But we appreciate you, family, and thank the Lord for you. And we appreciate that you asked me and Bobby to say a few words about your mother. And the good part is that everything's good with her, as far as we know, between her and God. You know, that means more than gold and rubies and everything you can think of as far as her riches. And, you know, it's Jesus. He told us, he said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. And he said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. What was he talking about? He's talking about the crucifixion, when he would be hanging between the living and the dead, and when the Roman soldier was pressed in the sword, and for where they come blood and water, that's what he was talking about. And he's been lifted up. And it's up to you and I, when God knocks at our heart door, to invite him in. He's not going to force himself. He's not going to knock your door down to get in. But he'll be glad to come in if you'll invite him. And you say, preacher, that's all y'all think about, and talking about the end of time ain't going to be long. It ain't as long as it has been. I don't know when it's going to be. If I ever tell you I do, say, that boy's a lying like a no telling what, because I don't know. And I don't know as it'd make any difference if you knew. How many of you ever been on court, Judy, and you didn't even think about it till the last week? You thought, man, I'm going to be on jury. I don't want to be on jury. But you was anyway. I can tell you how to get off of it. Don't tell nobody I told you this. Every time they ask you something, say, huh? And about the fourth time you tell them that, they'll say, you can go home. Because you can't hear, they don't want you. No, it don't cost you nothing. But Willie Mae, she's fought a good fight. And, you know, when I was reading in there, I thought, good gracious, I didn't know this girl was born in Mississippi. Didn't know she had Mississippi blood in her. But, you know, a lot of things we don't know. But like I said, she's always been a friend of me. And when her and Alvy was courting and running up and down the road, having a good old time. Anyway, we thought we was. And Alvy was in the service during a lot of their courting time, in and out. But there's one thing for sure. She loved every one of y'all. She loved all the grand younguns, son-in-laws, the whole nine yards. And like the grandson said, she'd, you know, holler when the meal was ready. And, you know, I don't blame a woman for putting stuff away, going to trouble cooking it. I got a grandson. We'll start eating. He'll get on the phone. No time to get on the phone. If somebody's on the phone, we got to call. He say, hey, fella, you're going to have to call me back. I'm fixing chow down. But it's like they say, people are funny. But we love all y'all. Appreciate you. And I'm not going to keep. I know it's that cold wind's blowing. We've seen the sun a little bit. Like to make a little announcement while we're here. A lot of you be going Monday over to Manor. It's not going to be the boxes this time. It'll be Friday from 9:30 to 1:30. And also, we'll have a funeral tomorrow evening over at Indian Mound, Thurston. And the body will come this evening at 4 o'clock and lie in the state till then. And visitation will start about 4:30 or 5 after the family views the body and everything. Then everybody else is welcome. Everybody here is welcome. The Bible says, I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that which we are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God. The dead in Christ shall first rise. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. And Jesus said, my Father's house are many mansions. And he said, if we're not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come again, that way where I am, there you may be also. And Thomas said, the way. And Jesus said, I am the way. And he is the only way. You'll not get to heaven any other way. You can't climb over. You can't go under. You got to come through Jesus Christ. He's the gate to heaven. May God bless you. Our Father, which is in heaven, Lord, we want to thank you today for everybody that's turned aside. Lord, we appreciate them coming in this cold evening, Lord, supporting this family. We thank you for this family, God, and we do pray you comfort them as you, the only comforter, Lord, that's able to comfort in times like these. And, Lord, I don't want to forget the good undertakers, Lord, and God, how they always look at us preachers, Lord, and appreciate them. Thank you for them. Lord, pray you'll look after them, keep a portion of health. And Lord, just help us all, God, to look to you. There are many others, Lord, that's sorrowing today over lost loved ones. We pray you'll comfort them. And Lord, we just thank you for all things in the sweet name of Jesus. And amen. We'll have one other song.
Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore.